Here in this country, another province is set to move ahead with its next phase of recovery. Newfoundland and Labrador eased some public health restrictions today, increasing restaurant capacity and allowing larger gatherings. And changes to the mask mandate could come in another week. The province has no confirmed cases of COVID-19 at the moment. It's a different story elsewhere in the country, where the Delta variant is causing numbers to rise. As Global's Sarah Comadina reports, that's raising concern among medical professionals that ending pandemic protocols too quickly will result in a harder hit from the next wave.
Enough! Enough is enough!
It was important for Neeja Bakshi to bring her daughters to the third day of rallies in Alberta, protesting the province's restriction rollback.
Only a few months away from being able to have our kids vaccinated, and so why rush it?
While the physician acknowledges restrictions eventually need to be lifted, she stresses right now just doesn't feel right.
Why are we doing this now? Why are we abandoning testing and tracing? And if we're going to do that, how are we going to mitigate the risk to our children, risk to the vulnerable population that cannot be vaccinated? And I think a bit more transparency is necessary.
Saskatchewan recently eased its COVID-19 restrictions, and it's now seeing a spike in infections. The province's active cases are climbing, reaching levels not seen in more than a month.
It's sort of like an expression of, wishing that COVID-19 is gone from these provinces, when in fact we may be seeing a beginning of a resurgence.
New Brunswick has already seen a resurgence of COVID-19 just days after dropping virtually all of its restrictions. But the growing cases in other provinces isn't stopping Newfoundland and Labrador from entering its stage two of reopening plan, 15 days ahead of schedule.
We'll be keeping a close eye on things. We'll see, we'll probably be able to learn from Alberta's experience in this regard.
Despite concerns from across the country, Alberta maintains its chief medical health officer's recommendations are informed by science, not politics. It comes as little comfort to Bakshi.
We aren't there with all of the things that we can be doing to protect our children. So it might be rooted in science, but timing is important.
Sarah Comadina, Global News, Edmonton.
As the Delta variant spreads across the country, experts say we could face a fourth wave in the pandemic. It may not prove as dire as previous waves, but it will target one group in particular, the unvaccinated. And as Karen Lieberman reports, that includes children.
The next wave, I think, will be largely in children.
The prediction should come as no surprise, says this emergency physician who points out this is now a pandemic of the unvaccinated, and children under 12 aren't yet eligible for the shot.
I think schools are going to be the front lines of this next wave. I don't expect the death tolls to be what they were. I don't expect the hospital usage and ICU occupancies will be what they were.
With over 80% of eligible Canadians now vaccinated with their first dose and approximately 65% fully vaccinated, doctors say the virus is likely to target those who have not had the vaccine at all. And come September,
I suspect that we will see what we've seen in England and what we're seeing in the States and some other countries. I think kids will be a particular focus. We'll see a lot more cases in kids.
These parents are conflicted about whether to vaccinate their 12-year-old daughter.
For kids, I don't know. It's a little bit early for me.
For me, it's better kids get vaccine and go to school. It's very important to go to school, I think.
Ontario Premier Doug Ford has said a back-to-school plan will be released early in the week and that the province is ready for September. Meantime, the Medical Officer of Health revealed there will be a separate set of rules for students based on their vaccination status.
If you are two-dose vaccinated plus 14 days, we'll offer you a test if you've been a contact of a high-risk person, so someone that's had ongoing fever and cough or increasing shortness of breath. If you test negative, you can go right back to school. You can go right back to work. If you are not immunized and you've been in contact with a high-risk contact, you'll be off for a minimum of 10 days.
And be subjected to two tests. Still, this Toronto mother says she will not be vaccinating her children who are under 12 when they are eligible.
If kids in 12 were like filling up the hospitals and the ICUs, it would be a completely different story, but they're not.
Although children are unlikely to get a severe case of COVID-19, this pediatric infectious disease expert says they do remain vulnerable to the virus and its long-lasting effects.
I've had families where you have healthy young teenagers that get COVID and then they have all the classical long hauler symptoms that adults have.
If they choose not to get the vaccine, she adds, they should learn from home. This mother hopes to avoid that.
He would love to be vaccinated too, and he will be soon, but yeah, he's looking forward to it. He wants to see his friends. He wants to be in class and learn.
Karen Lieberman, Global News, Toronto.